Stay strong for your state of mind. Got my boy to hold the bill, he said he pay me back. I don't care, I just hope that nigga got my back. Be concerned with the company you keep. My circle better hold me up when a nigga weak. My chick better have that breakfast ready in the morning, cause I solemnly swear to always give her that McLovin. Shout out all my niggas honoring her highness. Even with no makeup and the heels ain't the highest, I be feeling all the love everywhere I go. They like you, that funny nigga with the hard flow. Pause, but I feel you. Good to know you got some people out there that just really, really feel you. Every time you open up your mouth, they just hear you. Whenever you feel low, they wanna heal you. That's word, loyalty costs a brick, but I need that. If you looking for a real one, I promise I could be that. Love's like a drug. It could take you and just break you when you still want hugs. You still want more, you ain't have enough. My best ex is the one that never left the cut. What's the irony in that? It don't exist. When someone say they love you, they be proving it. And everything you need is at home. And home is where the heart is, you already know. Yeah. He want a bag, I tell him why. Being broke is a state of mind.
This is Will Nunziata, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film. And today I am thrilled to be speaking with the acclaimed rapper, producer, songwriter, Brendan. Brendan, how are you?
I'm good. I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing much better speaking with you, my friend. And I'm so excited. The audience just got a little sneak peek of your amazing talent with the music video for your latest song, State of Mind. Talk to me, Brendan, a little bit about the impetus for the creation of that song and the music video for it.
So I got with a new producer and also a friend of mine that got added to my small team. And we were working on some music, and we actually, that was the first song that we worked on together. It was something that just, I don't know, I guess it was something that stemmed from inside. I've been struggling, or kind of maybe not struggling, but I've been more aware of my state of mind and my mental health in life more recently, now than ever. And that was just a song that was actually kind of like an ode to positive thinking, an ode to looking at the bright things in life and being grateful for everything that you have. And that's where that song came from. And I'm before my mental state, but it's only booing, like bring awareness to it and telling people about it and checking what's going on inside internally is very, very important. And that's what definitely where that song comes from. Always checking on your state of mind, always checking on. Definitely. You may have things inside you that you don't really notice, but always check in with yourself. I think it's very important. So.
Brendan, that's amazing. And even though our connection is a little wonky, your message is loud and clear, my friend. And thank you for being vulnerable as an artist, because obviously it's been these past 18 months that not only humans, but especially artists have been going through it. And artists of all disciplines, and I include, and that includes from in my mind, I think athletes are artists in their own way. You have Naomi Osaka, Simone Biles, a lot of people coming out, speaking about the strength of admitting one's mental illnesses and the strength of moving through it. And, you know, being someone who has struggled with mental illness, I thank you for that song. And I thank you for being so open about it. And I just think about the young Wills and Brendans of the world who have someone like you to look up to with a song like that.
I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
Well, Brendan, obviously it's been a time of looking within. We've been still for a moment to really think about what is there in our life to be grateful for. And I'm curious, as we move forward, what you're most excited about as the world starts to open up. Are there any new songs or any new pieces of music that you're excited to get out into the world sooner rather than later?
Yes, definitely. So when the pandemic hit, and also going into this year, I've worked on a ton of new music. So I already have things already put in place and kind of organized for next year, starting in January. So I'm very, very excited. It's going to be a lot of vulnerability. It's going to be a lot of, I feel like we're now that I've found some sort of, I guess, niche, I would say, and just being vulnerable and just talking about real issues and just overall just telling my story. I think more than just a rapper and a poet and an artist, I'm a storyteller and I love stories. Even as a kid, I loved telling stories of mine, reading stories about others, telling other people's stories. So yeah, it's going to be a lot of storytelling and just a look into my life and everything I've been going through, thinking, feeling, all that good stuff.
That's amazing. You know, Brendan, I think that's what makes you not a second-rate version of someone else, but a first-rate version of yourself, because you're able, and you've obviously done the work on yourself to be able to lend your personal story, all the mess and imperfections and all, but that's what makes you relatable, my friend. And I think as a director looking at you, that's what gives you that extra it factor. And I'm curious of... You know, after especially putting out the song State of Mind, I'm curious, have you been receiving messages from people in how much it's moved them and how much they can relate to it?
Yeah. I've actually gotten overwhelming responses, humbling responses, I would say, of people who really enjoyed the song, more than just enjoyed the song, but really took something from it. And it's extremely grateful, humbling and amazing experience to put out something out to the world that means a lot to you, and it being received in a way that you couldn't really imagine that it can be received. So yeah, I'm very grateful for that.
Absolutely. Well, listen, before I ask my final question, I want to let everyone know for more on the incredible Brendan. Again, not only a rapper, producer, and songwriter, but like he said, an amazing storyteller. You can read more about him right below this video. And Brendan, final question for you, my friend. With this new Phoenix 360 app, you're not only going to be able to connect with artists and fans around the country, but around the world. What are you most excited about in terms of the ability now to collaborate and connect with artists in different countries?
That is a huge door open for opportunity, for connection. I feel like you don't really know what's going on in the world until you step into it. So I'm looking forward to connecting with artists, maybe traveling to different places in the world and just not just sharing my story, but actually collaborating and helping other artists and share their stories and connecting our fan bases and all that good stuff. And it's just a great opportunity. It's always a great opportunity to have an open door in collaborating with people, not just in your neighborhood, regionally, nationally, but around the globe. So I think that's a dope thing that I'm very, very looking forward to.
Absolutely. I mean, and look at knowing the CEOs and their friends, their North Stars truly to not only connect artists, but to also, you know, finally allow them to make a living that they deserve to make. And the fact of the matter is, Brendan, not only your music, but your story is universal. Your story is transcendent of language and location. And the fact that you're able and willing to not only share your story, but collaborate with others to share theirs is incredible. And I can't wait to continue to watch your star rise. And I'm grateful for your time today.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate this, Will. Thank you.
Thank you.